This is the JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe.
All right, this bus driver left 40 elementary kids at the wrong bus stop last week. It was pretty damn cold. So just do better at your job, I guess.
Just leaving Clear Sky Elementary School Monday afternoon gave kids a bad gut feeling.
We got on the bus and there was a substitute and he wouldn't let us leave the school until we stopped talking.
Getting out of the parking lot would be the least of these sisters' worries. Caitlin on the left and Kira on the right.
I'm 7, she's 10. So he finally left and he was skipping all the kids' stop. And when I mean all the kids, I mean all the kids. And we felt like when he was driving and missing our stops, like we were getting kidnapped.
The kids say their bus driver ended up 2 miles away from the school at the corner of Wolfensberger and Auburn with a bus full of about 40 kids.
He stopped right here at this intersection, like right here. And he said, everybody get off my bus.
They say it was around 5 o'clock.
And then everybody was like stressing, like crying.
Getting dark and cold.
And we forgot our jackets on the bus because out of stress. Yeah, we were shivering. Me and my little sister, we live like 2 miles away from here. So we had like no idea what to do.
A stranger offered the girls a ride and helped the girls call their mom, Ashley Stark.
I was absolutely petrified. And for a stranger to call me and tell me that she had my children in the car, and they were crying and screaming and bright red and frozen.
She says it's not something she can just let go.
This wasn't an honest mistake or a slip up. There was a lot of different ways that this driver could have handled this.
Caitlin and Kira's new ride to school.
You're looking at her.
And other parents will not stop until they get to the bottom of what happened on the bus.
It was super, super scary.
It's just unfathomable. And I think that there definitely needs to be some accountability on the side of the Department of Transportation.
Yeah.
Those kids are very well spoken.
Yeah.
Wow.
They were cute as hell. They're so funny.
They're like totally stressed and dying, and we didn't know what to do.
Left our coat there.
Right.
Yeah. The dude left 40 kids.
So I got out a piece of paper and drew a little picture of my dying best friend here on the side of the road in the ditch.
Right. Well, what the hell happened to the rest of the kids?
So... We found half of them. The other two, one's up in a tree. Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Substitute drunk driver, bus driver, I assume.
It wasn't drunk. It doesn't say that. No. Thankfully that the right person picked up those girls.
I'd like to have an adult version of that. You're on a Greyhound bus. And you sit up and you go, hey, dude, I think that's Des Moines. I wanted to get off there. Too late now. We're just going to keep on going. See where it ends up.
Yeah. The Douglas County School District sent an apology email on Wednesday to the families of the students on the bus saying the driver is no longer employed by the district. It said on Monday, a relief driver was covering Route 253. Relief drivers are full-time employees who step in as needed across our 850-square-mile district. That's what the district's chief operations officer, Rich Cosgrove, said in the email. Your child's route consists of 12 stops. On the third stop on Monday afternoon, the bus stopped just short of the usual location, leading to some confusion. At that time, the remaining 40 students on the bus all exited, with many getting off at the wrong bus stop. Regrettably, the driver did not follow protocol when this happened. The driver should have immediately notified the transportation dispatch. The driver shared an apology for the incident on Wednesday. I would just like to apologize. I'm sorry. I wish I had done better. He said he was unfamiliar with the route and his tablet wasn't working, so he asked the kids for directions. When asked if he felt like he did his job keeping the kids safe, he said, no, I don't. I didn't think about the fact that I had kids who got off the bus and this wasn't their stop. I was just stunned. In the apology email, Cosgrove assured that the district is actively reinforcing our safety procedures with all of our drivers, calling the incident troubling. Well, isn't this the problem with just having the tablets, right? And why couldn't he have called dispatch and been like,
right,
hey, walk me through all the different stops?
Right.
You know?
He panicked. Whatever.
Right. District noted that some parents have asked to view video footage from the bus during the incident, but the footage won't be released as an active investigation with the Castle Rock Police Department is underway.
Yeah, it sounds like somebody might be covering something up to cover up the person that hired the idiot bus driver.
I don't know.
At the school.
Well, and it's not, like, he wouldn't even move the bus until they all stopped talking. Like,
yeah.
It's a bus full of elementary kids. Like, I get making him to be, like, quiet down a little bit.
Right, right.
You know, that's when you're like, you're at a 10, I need you at a 5.
Yeah, how do you police that? Did you know in Alcatraz, I was in San Francisco, I'm geeked out a little bit. The first 2-3 years, they tried to do a no-talk policy with the inmates at Alcatraz.
What?
And then after a couple of years, yeah, it was causing fights complete frustration, and it drove the prisoners crazy. And then they had to, a new warden came in and they dropped it.
Yeah, that seems like.
They were like beating guys for talking.
Cruel and unusual.
At lunch, exactly. And then things calmed down.
Yeah.
Because we got to talk.
That's wild.
We got to talk.
Maybe this guy recently went to Alcatraz and was like,
right.
I like that idea.
He's going to check himself in and close the door. I deserve this.
That's crazy,
is the craziest story.
He's just going to leave elementary school kids. I'm assuming the other 38 kids got home okay.
I would love to hear, how many other kids got picked up? And why did she only pick up one? Did they scatter?
Well, this lady picked up two. It was a stranger that picked up the two girls.
Right.
But where were the other ones?
What kid is going to want to get on a damn bus again?
No kidding. Well, that's why that mom was like, I'm driving my kids now.
Yes. I mean, I don't know if you... Well, you need to investigate the hiring system or something.
Mm-hmm.
I know that there are bus driver shortages everywhere.
Oh, yeah.
I guess somebody in my neighborhood drives a bus, leaves it right out on the street.
Mm-hmm.
The HOA would have a fit with that, but
yeah. So the driver's saying this. So this other article is saying I did not kick the kids off the bus.
No.
It's been said in the media that some of the kids said I told them to get off the bus, and that is not correct. I said nothing to them. I opened the door. They knew that this was at least close to where they were supposed to get off, and they were just getting off. So yeah. I don't know. It's still, I mean, he didn't know the route at all.
Right. That's why I think there's a cover-up. It feels like they're covering mm-hmm. up somebody whose job it was to they didn't do a background check or whatever. They didn't vet the drunk substitute bus driver.
Well, they got video of it, so we'll find out.
Yeah.
We'll find out eventually.
Yeah. I'm letting the kids next for Halloween. I'm going to drop them all off at a cemetery out in the country and just see what happens. Because I like torturing children. It's what I do. Damn. Hello.
Hey, how's that a good excuse? He doesn't know the route. 40 kids don't get off on the same damn bus stop ever.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Unless they're at school.
Was he 90? How does it?
And he is older.
Is that too young to have a cell phone? It must be.
10.
Now, 10, I know. What do you parents do? How do you do that?
It's getting younger and younger.
Can't you get a phone without the porn on it and stuff?
Yeah, you can.
Yeah, right. Nobody had a cell phone. Unbelievable. And then why were the coats? Oh, so many questions.
Mm-hmm.
Leave me your coats. Maybe he wanted to... I'm trying to think of some reason you'd want 40 kids' coats. What's that all about?
Yeah, he directed the children to quiet down before he began driving. The ones in the back weren't even listening, so I got the kids maybe in the first 5 or 6 rows to quiet down and get in their seats and sit. And I walked down the aisle and spoke to the older kids in the back, and they persisted in talking, so I got a little louder, and they stopped talking as loudly, and they sat down because they had no choice. I was right there. I said, you know, I can be as tough as I need to be to get you to behave in the bus.
Okay.
As the bus
He's a bully!
As the bus proceeded along the route, he said the tablet that provides him with directions began malfunctioning.
All right.
Let me make it clear to you that this was the first time I had driven that route in that direction, and so I was dependent on the tablet to be clear to where I would go. Yeah. And it was dusk, a little harder to read the street signs. I knew that we had turned prematurely. I saw the parents on the side of the road. I knew I was on the wrong side of the road, but because they were all there, I felt it was okay to stop there. Johnson said once at the third location, which was not the correct bus stop, all 40 children lined up to exit the bus. He was alarmed but claimed he was working to log which children departed the bus electronically, which he's required to do. Every route I've ever driven for more than a couple of weeks, I know all the children's names and I know all the stops where they get on and off. I don't know any of these children, and I don't know which stops they get off. So even if I looked at them, I wouldn't know where they should go, and I have to rely upon their knowledge of where they're getting off. I recognize I could have done better at the stop when the rest of the kids got off the bus, and it was bizarre for me, and I think I was really stunned by it, and I didn't know what to do. This has never happened before. I never, ever had kids pile out of the bus and get off at a stop.
Yeah, well, kids are tough. It was interesting to hear somebody actually own up to their actions and apologize. That's right. Refreshing.
Right, that's new.
Heard that in a decade. but 80? I don't know. I don't know about that one.
I don't know
if I'd want my kid on a bus with an 80-year-old. Bottom line.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I wouldn't. But then again, I wouldn't put an 80-year-old in jail for that.
So I guess the district switched to a different tablet system a couple months ago.
Yeah, he was confused.
And they've been making adjustments, and the tablets have started to malfunction.
Yeah, it's just weird. It's almost, I don't know. He's 80, and he hit his BS toll with the kids. So it sounds like something else was going on there. Weird stuff. Well, nobody died.
Everybody's okay.
Yeah, there was a story last week about that parent that lets their kid walk everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you want it? You want your kids to walk everywhere or you don't?
Right. Yep, exactly.
Because here's a chance you get to walk, get some exercise, maybe lose a couple of toes to frostbite. Otherwise, everybody's going to be okay. But if I knew there was an 80-year-old driving my kid, I don't think I would care for that.
Well, and that being so reliant on that tablet.
Yeah, right.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that that's the problem, isn't it?
Yep. I think he got frustrated, confused, overwhelmed by technology.
And it's dark out.
It's dark out. He panicked, and that's what senior citizens do. They panic, and they toss children out of buses. I've heard this.
a million times.
I've heard this story a million times.
Yep.
That's the nightmare.
Replay today, the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and Dee. JJO.
Hello. Chuck Woolery died on Saturday. He was 83. He hosted a bunch of game shows. Probably best known for Love Connection from 1983 to 1994. It was online dating before the internet, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Here, let's...
This is Francie. She's divorced and ready for marriage again. Which one of these men did she choose? Which one will our audience choose? Now, here to tell us more about Love Connection is our host, Chuck Woolery.
We've compiled a videotape library of hundreds of attractive and available single people. We select some of those singles and we show them three videotapes. They choose the one they're most attracted to and go out on a date. Then they come here and they tell us what happened on their date. So to begin, let's meet a woman who says she's irresponsible, loves to be in love. Please welcome Francie Wallace. Francie.
I need something really romantic. Someone that smokes and drinks cigarettes.
Smokes and drinks cigarettes, yeah.
And drinks cocktails and can lift me.
Oh, Francie.
My kind of gal.
Sounds like a loose lady.
That's a challenge because she's 380 pounds. Right. That's why she said it. Yeah. If he can lift me. I'm not very stable. If he could lift me back up, that'd be great. He's a very strong man.
Now, I guess he actually started off as a musician. He was in a folk group called the Bordermen. And then later in a psychedelic pop duo called the Avant-Garde, which had a top 40 hit.
Really?
Yeah, called Naturally Stoned.
I did not know this.
So here's Chuck singing lead.
They say grow up, put your mind on what you have to do. But I know I can never make it, baby, without you. I can get a good vibration when I put my mind on you alone. I can get a real sensation, feel like I'm naturally stoned. Naturally stoned.
Wow.
That's kinda neat.
You know what that reminds me of?
That's pretty cool.
Reminds me of what's his name in Spinal Tap that was in the band that did the song The Flower People. Have you seen Spinal Tap?
No, I've just seen clips.
Yeah. And I can't remember the band they were in, but the blonde dude. Why am I forgetting his name? But they listen to the flower people. You know, hippie stoners singing about God knows what.
Right.
Back in the day. That was actually not horrible.
It was pretty cool.
That was okay.
Yeah. He was the original host of Wheel of Fortune.
Yeah.
He hosted Scrabble.
Oh.
1984 to 1990, and then a brief revival in 93. He hosted Greed on Fox from 1999 to 2000.
Mm-hmm.
Lingo on the Game Show Network from 2002 to 2007.
Don't remember that. But we used to watch Love. And I remember now it's coming back to me when we did a Love Connection version on the radio. We would have listeners vote on what dude should go with the chick.
Okay.
So we kind of copied it.
Yeah.
We did our own version of it, which turned out pretty funny. But
so in 1963, he was a wine consultant.
Wow.
Did you know that?
Mm-mm.
And he worked for Wasserstrom Wine and Import Company in Columbus, Ohio.
Wow.
Yeah.
Middle of the country. What's he doing in Columbus?
Oh, well, he was born in Kentucky.
Okay.
Yeah. Look at that. From 2012 to 2014, he had a nationally syndicated radio commentary show, Save Us, Chuck Woolery.
Well, I know he was a Trumper. I know he was a conspiracy nut.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Yeah. He was I think he made headlines. I think he didn't believe. I thought he thought COVID was a government inside fake news.
Okay.
and then I think his son died from it or something. I don't know. I don't remember.
Oh no.
But no, he was he went down a rabbit hole.
Oh yeah, look at this. Yeah. He's accused of anti-Semitism after series of tweets.
Yeah. I think he got crazy at the end.
Yeah, well, he's in that age range.
Yes. And then what's her name's dad?
Married five times.
Whoa.
You tell me that you're trying to preserve the sanctity of marriage when you've been married five times, you son of a bitch.
Whoops.
Yeah.
You know, if he was still alive, Trump would probably name him to a cabinet position. For my energy secretary, I think I'll nominate a game show host. Is anyone looking?
Look at that. On July 12, 2020, he tweeted that the CDC, doctors, the media, and the Democratic Party were lying about the COVID-19 pandemic.
Yeah.
Trump retweeted that. And then the following day, literally the next day, he tweeted that his son tested positive for COVID and that the COVID-19 pandemic is real.
Those are fake bodies. Those aren't real COVID deaths.
Jesus.
I know it's not. Yeah, strange stuff.
Is it strange?
I mean, even when you... whatever fits the narrative, man.
There it is, buddy.
Whatever Kool-Aid you drink, buddy. I guess you can make yourself believe anything. Whatever.
Oh, well, yeah. That's just it, dude.
But, yes, COVID. Oh,
Chuck.
It has ruined many a family. But, in the end, I mean, COVID, we just, I'm not saying we overreacted. We didn't know what to do. But I think some of it was smoke and mirrors. But to deny COVID makes you a lunatic.
Right. I will agree. We didn't know what was going on. Could have we known more? Yes.
Yeah.
But.
We did what we could with what we had.
Yeah. And then it just got weird. It just got really weird because people dug their heels in.
Mm-hmm.
And then it just became...
Well, it became political, too.
Right. And then it became political.
Mm-hmm.
And then it was like, well, all right. Now it's just craziness. Now it's just... And then nothing made sense. How are you going to tell me that this small business needs to not have any people in it, but we can all go to Menards.
Mm-hmm.
This doesn't make any sense. Like, it just got stupid. It just got stupid.
Well, where will they bury old Chuck, the old Chuckster?
Oh, Chuck. I don't. They're going to launch him into space.
What do you say for Kentucky, huh? Take him up into...
Yeah, he died in Texas. He was born in Kentucky. He died in Texas.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
So, all right. Well, let's give him...
Give it to him.
Dead, Jim. He's dead.
He's dead, Doctor.
He's dead, Jim. He's dead. He's dead, Captain.
He'll die, Jim.
He's dead. He's dead, Jim.
Dead.
The man is dead. He's dead.
He's dead.
He's dead, sir.
He's dead, Jim. He's dead, Jim.
He's dead, Jim.
That man's dead back there.
She's dead.
He's dead.
He must be dead. He was worse than dead. His brain is gone.
Captain is dead.
He's dead, Captain.
He's dead, Jim.
Is this a dead man, Doctor?
Very dead, Mr. Spock.
Let her go, Jim. He's dead.
He's dead.
She's dead.
We're all gonna die. Ah, yeah.
Yeah, we're all gonna die.
Yeah,
we're all gonna die.
You can learn a lot listening to podcasts.
And only 3 countries in the world don't use the metric system?
Or you can listen to this one.
I can't remember where I went Friday. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. What did I do on Friday? I got to check my calendar.
If anybody saw me Friday, call.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast.
I literally have no idea where I was Friday.
Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.
With Thanksgiving just around the corner. coming up on Thursday here. Do you guys go to family members,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Oh, my God. Do you guys do the traditional spread?
Yes.
Okay. So turkey, sweet potatoes, mashed potatoes, stuffing.
Yes, that's correct, Senator.
Okay. And then do you drink cocktails as well? Wine?
Yeah, I probably do. I enjoy some wine with my turkey.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the one day I do like some wine.
One day. You like wine.
I do like wine, but it's nice. It's luxurious, and I don't have to pay for it. So I'm like, I'll take the whatever right. You got. Yeah.
Are you a dessert guy?
Oh, sure. Got to save a little room for whatever's hanging out.
Yeah.
Something.
What kind of dessert do you usually do?
Something iced, like a pumpkin bar or something. Whatever's there.
Okay, a new report looked at how many calories people are downing at the Thanksgiving table. The average American caloric intake during the Thanksgiving meal is right around 2,000 calories, which doesn't seem that bad. You're supposed to get around 1,600 to 3,000 calories per day. Of course, that varies on a bunch of different things, age, weight, activity level, etc. So that's the whole day, which I think a lot of people don't really eat all day until the Thanksgiving meal. That's pretty much your meal of the day.
That's what I try to save up for.
You know? Right. Yeah, totally.
I try not to eat it all in 1 minute either. I try to savor the whole day.
Let's talk about them deviled eggs, you some bitch.
Because there's so much food, you got to take a couple of laps around there.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah, buddy.
Get it all in there.
But some people are like, they're not even kidding themselves. 14% of people are planning to eat over 3,000 calories. 4% are planning to eat over 5,000 calories, which if you're doing like them high-powered beers or whatever, it doesn't really take long to get to that level. You know what I'm saying? Thursday really isn't the end of it. The average person will also be eating about 2,270 calories worth of leftovers.
Yeah.
Nearly 40% of people say they'd eat a lot more than that. 27% said 3,000 calories in leftovers, while 9% is like, nah, I'm eating 5,000 calories worth of leftovers.
It's like a brutal four-day run.
Yeah.
I mean, just so much eating and all over the place. You're going out.
Yeah, we said if there's anything left after Friday, it's getting tossed. Yeah. Everything gets tossed Saturday morning.
Right.
We're not having it in the house. That's the plan. But, you know, the big day is Thursday.
The big day.
Thursday.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, let's quickly talk about cranberries.
Oh.
Do you do the cranberry sauce?
Yeah, I do love cranberries.
Is there a certain way that you like it? Some people don't like the canned cranberry, you know, where it's just like shaped like the can.
Mm-hmm.
But do you have a preference for cranberry?
No. Whatever you got.
Right.
How do you do it? How do you do it?
I don't care either way. I like it from the can. I like it just like the jellied kind or whatever.
Sure.
I like the fancy kind.
Just simple sauce. Yeah. Whatever you got, man. I don't care.
We're getting a homemade kind this year, which was really tasty. I had it in years past. It was pretty
good. Like a pie would be fantastic.
Oh, man.
Not a problem.
And you're just cranning it up.
Love cranberries.
Yeah, well, and it's a huge export from Wisconsin. What a
little cobbler. A little cobbler coming in.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
A little cranberry wine would be fine.
I got a shout out to Angelo's Pizza in McFarland. They do have the Gobbler Pizza right now, which is the Thanksgiving pizza. It's got like stuffing and everything
nice.
On it. Yeah, crazy.
Nice.
What a time to be alive. Newer, gayer, dumber, that's JJO News.
Yeah, there's a, where did I see this at? Let me see this. I had a story for you. Where did I have it at?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Do I have it ready to go? I don't.
Here, I have a... Does Johnny have a story ready?
I can't even find it. Is this, oh, here it is.
Oh.
Sorry. It's like a shopping tip. Like a heads up here. They put out a health warning over fake perfume.
And like knockoff perfume?
Knockoff for Christmas that you buy for perfume. Guess what's, I'll double down here. Guess what's in the perfume?
Oh, what's in the knockoff perfume?
You've had a glass or two of this in your life.
Piss.
Yes, it's true. The health warning over fake perfume that contains human urine.
Okay.
Urine, my thoughts and prayers.
We stayed at a hotel for El King up north.
And drank pee.
And they had the shower gel and the conditioner and the shampoo were all in
bottles.
Right.
Yeah.
And
which is nice.
I'm telling you.
You gotta mess with that soap.
Somebody pissed in one of those.
Oh,
I swear to God.
Oh, that is Udo wrong. Oh no.
Because I swear there's no way that body soap was supposed to smell that way. There's no way. Anyway, go on.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
And how long did it take you to figure that out?
As soon as I squirted it out.
What was the consistency of the lather or what? Wait, which bottle did it come out of?
The body gel.
The body gel. So the body wash.
And it was runny, which was the first indication.
Smelled like asparagus.
And I was like, oh my God. And then it stunk. And I was like, somebody peed in there.
Oh no.
For sure.
No.
Yeah. Which was my big fear about them going to these, you know, the big containers and leaving them in the room was that, ejaculation was the big fear.
Yeah, but now we're
just peeing and everything.
Well, now there's no way I'm not going to ejaculate into the body gel tube at the next hotel I stay.
So now I'm like, well, I'm going to start bringing my own stuff all the time.
That's pretty funny.
Oh, my God. It was so gross.
I mean, it's so naughty. It's so naughty.
It's gross. Yeah, I know. And then
I only have enough energy at my age to do one of those a week, and I got to save it up for the old ball and chain. But maybe I could scoop a little and put it into the bottle.
Jesus.
I know what Lance would say if he was here, and I'm not going to say it because I'll get kicked off the radio. That's the creepy. That's the creepy.
I swear to God.
Hotel stories everybody's afraid of.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, it was real thin, probably.
Yeah, the viscosity was not correct.
And then did you know it once it instantly got on your hand, or did you?
Well,
have to
I was like, that's weird. And then when I went to
Amber,
and I was like,
here, Amber, you try this, see if you like it.
That's when I learned the difference between a garbanzo bean and a chickpea. And then when I put it on my skin, I was like, smells bad.
Oh,
and
no.
Then, yeah.
Because it's probably been in there forever.
Probably.
How often do you think they empty those things?
Never.
Would you prefer a bar of soap?
Yes.
Over,
100%.
Well, now that you've said that, you've just, everybody now. Yeah. Is going to fear the bottle condition.
That was. Which I'm all for, like, getting rid of the little plastic one-use bottles. I'm all for that.
I always smell it first before I put the shampoo on and stuff. I guess I would kind of know if it was urine-y, runny, thin.
Yeah, well, you know? I don't think argan oil smells like pee. I really don't.
I mean, it's not going to hurt you eventually. You're not.
Well, I was not looking for that at that particular time.
Well, you should have let them know at the front desk. They would have put you in the high roller suite where there's no urine mixed in with the body gel.
I didn't think I had to ask for that.
Grandma smells like pee-pee.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
Let's see if we have some relatable. Hi, tell me about your nightmare body gel story.
You think that R. Kelly...
Yes, we do. Thank you. Hi, how's it going?
Hey, I'm speaking of peeing and things. I'm wondering how many ball washers at the Oaks have been peed in and have bodily fluids.
Oh, Did you think somebody would ejaculate into a ball washer?
Oh, no.
I've only done that once, but I've never peed in
one. Okay. So. That's a fair... Well, yeah, one seems like a lot more trouble than the other, but I don't know. I'll take up my little test strip for my hot tub and soak it in the ball washer and see what's going on. The pH load in here is running very high. Hello?
Hey, my boys used to say that, too, is never use the towel hanging from the ball washer.
Oh.
You know how bad somebody would get their you-know-what beat if I walked up and seen somebody peeing on that?
Well, yeah, I've never seen that, actually, before. I swear to God, I've never seen that. And I golf with some real degenerates, trust me.
Yeah.
Well, clearly with your one friend with the lottery tickets. But here's my question with that. If that guy would have won 10 grand, then what would you have done?
Right. $4
Yeah.
With your $4.
Yeah, I guess I would have followed him around and begged for money. I don't know what would have happened, but goddamn, what a crazy story that was. It's weird to see your money get used like that, you know? I mean, I don't know. It would have been kind of cool, I guess. And we would have bought a boat together and sailed off into the sunset. Who knows?
Mm-hmm.
All right, man.
You overboard, though.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's exactly correct.
Damn.
Anyways, where was I? Perfume. That one kind of came off the rail there for a minute. Where's my story? I can't even find it.
Oh, not again.
Where's my story?
Not again.
I just had it.
What the hell, dude?
Da, 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 da. Play the thing. Da, 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 da. An appalling health warning issued over what could actually be in fake perfume. People can be tempted by the cheap price, by lab experiments that reveal these scents could actually contain human urine. Many feel that high-class perfumes offer an air of luxury, along with premium price tag to match. Yet people often overlooking the quality of what they're actually getting, buying these knockoff discounted perfumes, might leave disappointed and damage your health. The Art Robinson fragrance expert at Half Price Perfumes, or in laboratory tests of samples seized by the police, shown fake perfume containing human urine.
Just get the real stuff, or don't get any at all.
Do not buy perfume out of the back of a truck in the Menards parking lot.
Jesus Christ! There used to be someone that worked here.
Aside from obvious downsides, urine holds a number of bacteria and other potentially harmful microorganisms. Counterfeit perfume lacks the preservatives and chemicals that stop bacteria from growing in higher-end perfume bottles. Never think about that,
do you? There's a reason why there's a price tag on that stuff.
When thrown together with unsanitary manufacturing conditions and low-quality ingredients, it all adds up to pee-pee. The experts noted that rashes, you know, this is like when they, what do they put in? I don't know about drugs. I don't do drugs. not mine anyways, but the, don't they, like cocaine, they find pee and feces.
This guy peed on it.
Thank you. That's the medical coroner, doctor guy looking at the pee-pee perfume. Isn't that true? They find, they analyze cocaine. It's got all this, you know, like animal urine and stuff.
I don't know about that.
Yeah. The expert noted that rashes, redness, and eczema, which I think is a white malt liquor.
Oh, I like that in my margaritas.
Are among the standard risks of counterfeit perfume. Loaded with harmful chemicals and pee-pee.
Pee-pee.
Which could trigger a reaction. Some of the chemicals, such as phthalates, can even disrupt your body's natural hormone production.
Well, that's not good.
Exposure to formaldehyde has been linked to increased risk of cancer, leukemia, other types of cancer. You don't wear perfume, do you?
I do sometimes, yeah. It's my Paracillin perfume. It's reasonably priced, and God damn it, it smells super good. You like it when I wear it. You're always like, oh, that's nice.
Yeah, Christy wears Dolce & Gabbana.
Yeah, my lady wears it.
Oh, that stuff.
It's nice. The light blue. Yeah.
It is boner time.
There's a light blue summer version that's really nice.
So good. I don't care if that stuff had whale vomit in it. I'd still think that was nice.
It's nice.
I love that stuff, man.
Yeah, it's super nice.
Hi, how's it going?
Okay, two things. Why is the phrase pissing your money away becoming practice?
I don't know.
She's looking it up right now.
Also, why does this sound like a story that was stolen from, like, Girl Who Farts in a Jar and sells it for money?
Well,
why is
I have
this
a reputable
so
source.
Similar?
Reputable sources.
Like, okay. I'm sure some girl seller out there is going to read this story and be like, you know, I could probably make money off that.
Listen, I have an alternative for you.
It's called Sex Panther by Odeon. It's illegal in 9 countries. Yep, it's made with bits of real panther, so you know it's good.
It's quite pungent.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, it's a formidable scent. It stings the nostrils. In a good way.
Yeah.
Brian, I'm going to be honest with you. That smells like pure gasoline.
They've done studies, you know. 60% of the time, it works every time.
That doesn't make sense.
What are you jabbing her up on over there, Brian?
Okay. So the phrase to piss all your money away was usually meant to, usually drinking it all away.
Oh,
so you'd spend all your money on booze and then piss it all
away. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That phrase works 60% of the time, all the time at my house. I'm always drinking.
Okay.
Naked.
Spraying the Dolce & Gabbana perfume on yourself.
I just want to be pretty. And oftentimes I am.
It's terrifying.
The Amazon delivery man can't keep his hands off me.
Dumbing down your smartphone. One podcast at a time. Listen, rate, and subscribe to the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
He's snickering out over there.
My People's Choice Award. I can order a little plaque for it. They sent me the email.
Like a gag gift?
No.
Oh.
It's not a gag gift. It's Madison.com, People's Choice.
Oh, that thing. Haven't you won that or something? What happens there?
Yeah, Yeah, me and Fish, top two DJs.
Oh, my God.
You were nowhere to be found.
Two people that couldn't deserve it more.
We were nowhere to be found.
Very happy for you.
But I have to pay for my plaque. That's what I'm laughing at. But I save money. You know, you if can, I get if can, I get two to five of them, I just get a deal.
You know what? I tell you what I'll do. I have a router at home because I'm pretty good at shop class. I'm gonna make my own plaque. Yeah. How much is it? What do they charge you?
$187.
Nice scam you got going there.
Right?
So I assume you're going to go plaqueless this year.
Oh, yeah. That's what I was snickering about.
I wonder if you don't order the plaque, they don't put you up for consideration next year.
Oh, man, is that funny. No.
Well,
that is
I'll get my...
It doesn't even say.
I'll have the design center at Edge Construction make you a plaque.
It doesn't even say what it was for. It just says D Biznatch, People's Choice.
Oh.
Madison.com, 2024.
Oh, my God.
It doesn't even say what I'm People's Choice for.
$187.
But if I get two to five, it's only $167.
Can't you like go to Etsy and get like a $20 little thing or something?
That's so funny. That is so
There's got to be somebody out there that can make you a plaque.
I don't want a plaque. Oh. But I just thought that was hilarious. Nice scam.
Who puts that on?
Madison.com.
Is that Madison Magazine?
So it's Wisconsin State Journal and all them.
Oh,
it's
yeah. Madison.com. Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Well, I could make you a shirt. I could iron some.
I don't need anything.
DJ.
I'm good.
Well, I feel bad. I mean,
don't feel bad.
You should get about a pen with your name on it.
No. I'm.
You want a hug?
No, I'm really good. I'm good. I just want to.
Come over here. Daddy wants to congratulate you. Come over. Come to Papa.
Oh, no.
So proud. Well, for all that trouble and hard work, you know, they throw you a bone.
Yeah, for $187.
Take your stupid award and shove it up your ass.
Look what.
You know, we're at a different level than the Academy Awards. They give you a bag full of $50,000 in skincare ointment and spa visits.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, no, from us, they just bleed us dry. That's awesome. Yeah. That's awesome.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe. Catch a new show every Monday through Friday, 6 till 10 a.m. on 94.1 JJO or streaming anywhere in the JJO app. Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.